I'm contemplating whether or not I want to do a Q&A for the characters of this world. So, might as well run through them real quick. Oh, you can see. You didn't see anything. Alright. So, of course you can ask... You can ask me anything, but... You can just ask me questions in the comments of any... Oh my god! In any video, so... It's not really a point in asking me anything, although you can. You lit. So here are the characters. I swear to... No. No. How the f... No. I said no. Snipe. So. Here are the characters that aren't me. First up on the list is Penny. Alternatively... God damn... First up is Penny, alternatively known as Bite the Bee, like a nanobite. Yep. She loves to tinker. She's pretty familiar with the jungle. And the whole entire reason she has these... Well... Like I said, she likes to tinker. If it's mechanical and it's a honey item, it's hers. Like this. I mean, this is the grand scheme. Look at this. And she also has another wrench just because, well, it's her trusty wrench. She has this. Just random bolts go. And this is her weapon, and this is her weapon. Yeah. Next up is Corruptia, a being of pure corruption with ancient shadow armor and shadow armor on. Her gig is, well, corruption items. So the Light's Bane, Nightmare Pickaxe, Sharp War Axe of the Night, and the Breaker are all her standard weapons. The needle spike is canonically just a giant piece of her body, just because she's not a shapeshifter, but she essentially can. Then the chain guillotines. Have you ever aura-aura'd somebody so fast that you use chains? Yeah, this is just very fitting for her. Next up, this, the Malice. Again, essentially just a lengthy shapeshift. Well, it's supposed to be anyway. Doesn't do much. That's fine. Next is the Spinal Tap. Have you ever flung your spine at somebody? This is pretty much it. And then this. So to make for the Vile Thorn, essentially this is... How do I put it? You know how the Xenomorph alien can use the tongue thing? The razor sharp tongue that has like the mouth on the end of it? Take off the mouth on the end and make it a spear, and that's pretty much what Corruptia does. Just a... Sounded like I just spat something. So yeah, so hard mode, she's not the best, but her goal is, well, like I said, just corruption items. And she has the Ball of Hurt. Yeah. Habisky. She has harpoon because get over here, and just another range option that apparently doesn't do too much. That's not too bad. I say it's not too bad because it's able to decently damage a harpy. Even on recall, wow. Then she has this, which apparently is a corruption item. And yeah, and a kite. Because yes. No. And because I forgot to put the worm hook on her. Hold on. All right, worm hook acquired. Oh my God. Yeah, that's corruption. Made of corruption, ask her whatever you want. Next up, say hello to the harpy on my team, Halo. She has the Star Fury. Yep. And then she has some platinum gear that I lent her. And a bow. Yeah, her inventory's got plenty of wormholes and plenty of potions, torches. Yep. So normally, because... Okay, so harpy wings because she's a harpy, but here's the fun thing. Normally her arms are her wings. But for Terraria's sake, and because making that cannon would be a nightmare, she can just use arms and have the wings on her back, or have her arms be the wings, each having their own merits. See? I got the skin tone a little wrong, okay? I'm sorry. But, she's a special harpy, so. Oh, no. Well, that didn't go so well. That really didn't go so well. What the frick? Don't worry, the next character I'm gonna show is gonna be able to shred you. Yeah, she's not made to be a fighter. She's just here. Hey guys, say hello to playable Plantera. So... Bonk. Oh, look. Still can fly. I'm going to explain that after. Don't worry. Here's, playable Plantera, ladies and gentlemen. So if you want to ask the boss with arguably the coolest theme, any questions, have at it. All right, have at it. I'll have to find, either me or the giant will have to be a translator, so I don't know. So, Thorn Chakram. Yes. So, you see the mini mouths, right, that I'm calling them? This one's supposed to be a fourth one. Canonically, I guess. Then the get the frick over here, which I know it doesn't drag enemies closer to you, it just, you're extending spiky roots, so, yeah, that's nice. Flower pal. Yeah, that's nice. Probably should have the arcane shackle on here, extra mana. Okay. So she can kind of swamp around whatever she needs to. She has an immunity to poison when she swaps out for more mana and other stuff. Yeah, anyway, the Glock. This. Now, I know it's kind of useless, but it's just because it's... just because it's essentially a middle finger. And then this. Which I know it doesn't really fit for Plantera, but... eh. He drops from her. Also, I know you can see this little fella. Anyway, that's the other one who can shred wyverns, which conveniently, while I was trying to get up here, one dive bombed and instantly regretted its decision. Next one. Now, if you thought one bee wasn't enough, here's the queen bee. She's kind and humble, and if she scolds you, somehow, if you manage to make her upset, just like Queen Bianca in Bug Fables, the only thing you can really do is feel bad. Yep. So she has this. this, which is from Plantera, but still. And, well, let's just say a wasp gun and a bee gun should probably go together. She has this. And this, because royalty and she... I'm not giving her flippers. You can't make me. But essentially, she can swim. I mean, so can Bite and the other bees, but, you know. Just thought I'd mention that. Yep, next character. And you can ask her anything, too. Next up is Queen Slime. Who has... only the hook. The volatile gelatin. Crystal Assassin pants and Crystal Assassin hood. If there's anything she should probably have, it's no. Oh no. That was not supposed to happen. Now she is Royal Gel. Oh no. Just having some technical difficulties, don't mind that. So yeah. All she has are the copper things and another crystal assassin hood and pants, along with volatile gelatin and the hook and the royal gel and the volatile gel and that. Yeah, that's Queen Slime, everybody. Ask her anything you want. Alright, next character. Next up is Slimia, the essentially a pink slime with king slime stuff. Who, she's normally just the kind fellow who does things in the background for people. And she has the other slime items too. She's not supposed to be fighting. Henceforth why she's doing little to no damage and is taking more than she should be. But she has the slime mount, so I guess that's pretty helpful. Because that does quite a lot of damage. For her, anyway. And then the slime gun. We'll get you eventually. We'll get you eventually, Harpy. Yep. That's Slimia. She's just really helpful and nice. Oh no. Yep. This is probably not gonna end well. Oh look, it didn't end well. Whoopsie daisy. Oh look, a Skeletron cloud. or Dungeon Guardian, either or. Yep. Now Slimia, she's very helpful and is in a lot of pain, so I'm going to go to the next character. Now you may be wondering why I have cultist wear on now. Well, for those who have played Just Shapes and Beats and know what this remix is from, I'm going to let this explain it. Somebody already know what it is, I swear to God. Yep. I took my phone off the charging for this. You know how Mothron can spawn in solar eclipse? In a solar eclipse, pardon. And do you remember Mothra, that one Godzilla monster that is a protector and is forced into conflict? Name of the monster, item, name and wings of the Godzilla monster. Well, it's actually an old film for Mothra, so she is her own thing. So I guess I just say Godzilla because that's what she most often appears nowadays. So yeah, I gave her this because I was like, well, she needs something to defend herself. Anyway, you can ask her some things. I mean, she has the wings. Yeah. Might as well give you a tour with the character that I apparently have. I decided to make another merchant character, just cause. And so far so good, but you're gonna see why I call this place the Gauntlet of Hell. There it is, gastropods. Well, there's not one, there's two, there's three. Oh my god. I feel like I'm fighting the twins. Wow, I made it. So normally I die at least three times. Yeah. Well, I have the merchant character for some reason. I just made him. So, yeah, that's fun. You can ask him stuff if you want. Yeah. Oh, come on. So. Hyping it up is very hard, but here she is. This remix is also made by Drakes. Crediting. And I played it because it's relevant. Cue Wyvern, please. No? Okay. I'll find one. I'll find a wyvern. Hold on. I know Plantera shreds them. Plantera shreds wyverns. But Empress, she just makes them stop existing. Okay, come on. I even colored the Shield of Cthulhu so she had her dash. See, I thought of everything. No, she doesn't have the light pit because that'd mean there's two of her. Love this. So, Wyvern, can you just appear, please? This is very anticlimactic. I'm just trying to get a Wyvern to show up, man. Come on. Come on. Please. Come on! Well, God damn it. That's the Empress. Feel free to ask her things. This is who was in the background of editing for the Prop Hunt But You Can Jump video. Watch that. That was funny. I still have trauma from the umbrella section. But it's worth it. Anywho, yeah. And that's all the characters I can reveal for right now, because there's a few that have yet to be met in the lore of... This is pretty much the Dream SMP, but in Terraria. Which it would be nice if Dream actually played Terraria. That would actually be interesting. I don't know if he has already or not, but either way. This one. And... this one. And not to mention, I gotta find the secret way down. So this is essentially what happened to the old base that was in part one. I showed a friend of mine over on this on Discord. I'm not going to say their name because I respect their privacy, but I'll say Mangle because that's their username. God, it's nice to have my weapons back. For the most part. Next. Oh yeah, balls, it was down here. So normally, ignore the little lip, that would be a one-hit kill, but you can see this little gravestone here and these special ones here all have lore to them. I'll probably make a separate video on that of me and everybody else's theories. No, 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 no. Okay. But no, the story is a little bit morbid, so. And this is the final character. I've already hinted at it, and yep. When we kill the lunatic cultist, that's where, where she comes in. And yeah, it's about all of them. So yeah, after making a video here, I'm gonna put it in the Return to Hard Mode playlist just because it's relevant. We'll do Return to Hard Mode Q&As for Terraria. I think that could be awesome. Okay, so if we're gonna do that, I'm gonna give you a heads up. Gummy has characters for each of the pillars. The Star Wanderer, Vortex Walker, Nebular Mage, and the Solar Warrior. So they have yet to show up in this world. Well, actually the mage did once. But I could probably find a way to get them here for a Q&A. I know I'm not really popular enough on YouTube with the subs and all to do Q&As, but it's still a nice passive thing. I'll let you pause and read this. Also, this will probably upload before I finish part two, so just know I'm working on part two right now. I'm stitching it together. It's probably not going to be as funny as part one, but I'm going to try, all right? Don't throw me into the gutter just yet. Phone hammer. God, no. I'm so used to fearing for fall damage, but I have wings and the flying insignia. How the frick? Okay. That, sure. Yeah, see you guys in part two, since that's the one I'm working on now.